this is Kristen, Science and Engineering Librarian. Today we're going to be having a brief overview of IEEE Xplore. IEEE stands for Institute of Electrical and Electronic Engineers, and we're going to be doing a basic search today, looking at some of the filtering options, and then looking at the article page to see what kind of information they have on there, which can help you decide whether or not you want to read the article, and it can also help you in finding other sources. Okay, we're going to start off at the library homepage and navigate to IEEE Xplore. To do that, we're going to go to the Databases A to Z button right here. And then you can browse in the eyes or just do a search for the name. Got it in here right here. Okay, here it is. We'll go ahead and click on it to launch the database. Okay, now that we're within IEEE Xplore, let's have a quick look at things before we do our search. Up here at the top are some other IEEE products. We're just going to stay in IEEE Xplore because we don't have access to all of these. Coming down just a little bit, if you want to browse to see what kinds of things IEEE Xplore has, then we can hover over this menu here, and it looks like we have books, conferences, courses, journals, and magazines, and standards. Now, as I said, we don't have access to all of these. If you're curious to know which particular things we do have access to, if you come under My Settings and what I can access, then it'll give you details for what we do and do not subscribe to right now. Let's go back to the homepage, though, because we can actually filter out what we do not have access once we do our search. Okay, so back at the main screen, let's go ahead and perform our search. We're going to look for offshore wind power. Okay, and then click search. All right, so here we are on the results page, and right up at the top, it gives us an overview of what kind of content we have for this search. There's a lot of conferences for this particular search. There are some journals and some standards, and it looks like we have books and magazines as well. But as I said, we don't have access to all of these things. So over here in this yellow box, it has right now all results. But let's just click on the subscribed content, and that'll limit it to what we actually have available. Okay, now that that's reloaded, we can see that our search result numbers have gone down, and the books have actually disappeared, so we don't have access to those. We still have a lot of conference papers, though, so let's say we just want a journal. We can limit it to just journals and click apply. Okay, so that's a lot more focused already. Let's have a look at some of the other filtering options that we have at the side. If we scroll down a little bit, then we can limit it to the year. Let's just say that we're looking for things from 2011 to 2020. I'll click apply in just a second, but we want to look at this other thing down at the bottom as well. If we go under publication topics, then here you can find a lot of suggestions for keywords. So often when you're searching, you don't find what you're looking for on the first one or two searches. So if you're kind of stumped for what other terms to throw in there to look for, this is a really good place to look for ideas. But let's just leave it as is and apply our year filter. Okay, so now we have a really focused list that's really cut down from what our original search was. We only have 525 things to look for now. So let's pick one of these and we'll look at the article page. Let's go with this one here. Okay, so once you have the article up, you've got a couple of options. If you want to just read the article in HTML on this website, then you can scroll down and you can read it that way, which is kind of handy. Or you can scroll back up and click to see the PDF, which is obviously much more convenient if you're printing it, but some people also prefer reading it that way. Let's go back to the page though, and we'll have a look at some of the other things that we've got on this page. Right next to the PDF button that we just clicked on is a Cite This button, and that gives you the citation to the article, which is really nice. You can choose to have it in plain text or in some of these other formats. So that's nice if you want to save the information for this article and come back to it. Coming down a little bit, we have the abstract and some of the other buttons that we have here. This little R is the references, so that's the bibliography for the paper. You can click on that and view that here. So we just looked at the references, which is the bibliography for this paper. But what's also neat is that we can look at the paper citations, which are all the papers that have cited this paper. So that's going forward in time. The references are going backward in time. We can click on that and view what those are. And we've actually got little links to those, so that's very convenient. Go back up to the top. What's also nice, if we come down here to the side, is the keywords. And we kind of mentioned the keywords already when we were looking at the search results. But once you find one of the articles or any of the articles that are really interesting to you, you can come down to this keywords section, and there's a couple of different categories for keywords. And again, you can get a lot of different ideas here and try those out in your searches, and maybe you'll come up with something else that is really helpful. Okay, we'll go back up to the top. All this is actually on the same page. It just bookmarks it to go down a little further the page. So if you wanted to save or share this article, we looked at the Cite This button, which gives you the citation for it. But you can also use this little share icon, and you can email it to yourself or to somebody else, which is kind of handy. Or you can use the DOI, which is right here. DOI stands for Digital Object Identifier. And if you use this, it's like the ISBN for a book, and that'll bring anybody, you or other people, back to this paper. So that's kind of like a permalink They don't really have permalinks in this database. They just have these sharing options that you can use. All right, that wraps up this video. This was just a very brief overview of IEEE Xplore. There's also advanced search options and more information available on the article pages to Xplore. So if you have any other questions, please do let us know. Thanks for watching.